Hi, this is Electronics. In this video I'm going to review the PAM8403 IC based Class D amplifier circuit. But before the video starts, be sure to subscribe and press the bell to get notified when I upload a new video. 5 amplifier circuits are shipped together on a single board, which can be broken down to separate circuits. Let's take a look at the datasheet. The PAM8403 is a Class D audio amplifier capable of 3 watts output to a 4 ohm load with the highest efficiency only by using 5 volt power supply. As the datasheet shows, it can achieve 90% efficiency. This means that the 90% of total energy consumption is used and only 10% of the energy is dissipated. Compared to the Class AB amplifier, which has an efficiency between 50 and 70%, the Class D is way more efficient. The price of the high efficiency is the quality of the audio. The Class D amplifiers are not good quality amplifiers. The output is a filtered high frequency modulated square wave, which I will explain in another video. This is how the output of a Class D amplifier looks on the oscilloscope without filtering. Returning to the PAM8403, this module has a filterless design, which means that it doesn't require an LC low-pass filter, because the coil of the speaker will be the low-pass filter. It is highly recommended to read the whole datasheet before starting any kind of test with this module. There are several instructions in the datasheet, what I do highly recommend to follow if you don't want to damage your board. Let's move on to the presentation of the board. The size of the board is 22 by 18.5 by 3 mm, so it is really small. It can fit in almost any small speaker project. It has a total of 9 connection pads, 3 for audio input, 2 for the 5 volts power supply and 4 for the stereo output. As the datasheet stated, the amplifier IC requires only a few external components, as you see a total of 10 resistors and capacitors. The amplifier IC is placed at the center of the board. On the backside, only a few thick traces can be seen. To power up and test the board, I have to solder wires so it will be easier to connect it to the breadboard. I speed up the video while I solder the wires on the board. After soldering, I place the PAM8403 on a breadboard. The power supply for this board will be a 2A 5V switch mode power supply, both from AliExpress. You can see a review video of this board by clicking on the card, or you can find the link in the description. I started the test with the XYBT mini Bluetooth receiver module connected to the input. The result was horrible, as you can hear the whole circuit had some kind of ground loop problem, so I had to use my phone as the signal source. The next test was better. I've used coils at the outputs to filter out high frequency, but the sound quality was still not good. The distortion what you hear is from the jumping of the speakers, so at the next test, I put some soft materials underneath the speakers. Without coil, the sound quality was a little bit better. When I turned the volume too high, the module just started to skip a few milliseconds and goes to full excursion when low frequency sounds came. This was probably from the phone because I was using an old Nokia which had a higher output signal than the Samsung, and the module just shuts down for a short time. In the next test, I've used the power resistor and the coil in series to measure the output. The multimeter measures the supply current drain and the oscilloscope the output of the right channel. I stopped the video here to point out the quiescent current is only 5.8 milliamps, which is really low, so this module is good for battery use. For this test, a 1 kHz signal is fed to the module using my phone. Slowly I increase the volume to the maximum to see the maximum RMS voltage. The current drain is around 180 milliamps for one channel, so for both channels it would be approximately 360 milliamps. This value was way too low for the dual channel 3 watts output. If the efficiency of the board would be 100%, with 400 milliamps current drain, the output power would be 1 watt output per channel, which is still far from the stated 3 watt output rating. Before I share bad values about this product, let's take a look at the oscilloscope. The RMS voltage is around 1.2 volts when the output is filtered. To calculate the output power from the RMS voltage, we take the square of the RMS voltage, which is 1.44, and divide it by 4, which ends up with a disappointing result of 0.36 watts. At this point I was thinking that the module might be damaged from the test or it is faulty from the factory, so I've replaced the module with a new one. This time I've tested it with a coil and speaker, but the result was similarly disappointing. Lastly, I've tested how low can this board go, and the result was surprising. At 100 Hz, the RMS voltage increased to 2 volts, which means the output power was 1 watt. After getting lower than 100 Hz, the output starts to attenuate, but I could go down to 30 Hz, where still the RMS voltage was above 1.2 volts. So this board can go really low if your signal source is good. Before I end the video, I want to share some more information about the board. The switching frequency is 260 kHz, so a passive low-pass filter with a cutoff frequency of 40 kHz will result a good quality audio. As stated at the beginning of the video, the Class D amplifiers are efficient and just a small amount of power is dissipated in form of heat, so this board does not require heatsink. The price for a single board ranges between 10 cents and 20 cents, so it is really cheap. It worth the money also if you buy it only for testing. Thank you for joining the review and the test of this board. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this.